Welcome! This video will show you how to activate your ctcLink account. Before you begin, you will need to have your ctcLink ID ready. For new students, your ctcLink ID is included in your admissions email. For returning students registered between January 2015 and winter quarter 2021, please have your old SID ready and on hand for the first time activation. The old SID will be used to obtain your new ctcLink ID. Finally, for former students registered any time before 2015, you will need to reapply to Edmonds College in order to obtain your new ctcLink ID. If you cannot locate your new ctcLink ID or old SID, please contact Enrollment Services to obtain this information. For new employees, your ctcLink ID will be included in your new hire packet from HR. Remember, you may always pause and rewind this video if needed. Let's begin. First, open a new web browser window and proceed to gateway.ctclink.us. You'll be brought to the ctcLink login page. Below the sign-in box, click on Activate Your Account. Here, you will be brought to the First Time Account Activation page. Enter your first name, last name, and date of birth. When entering your date of birth, be sure to enter the slashes and follow the format of month, day, and year. You may also click on the calendar icon to enter your birth date. If you have your ctcLink ID, you may leave the menu item ctcLink ID New as is and enter your ctcLink ID. If you have an old SID, click on the drop-down menu and select SID Old. Now you may enter your SID. After you have entered all of the requested information, click on Submit. If successful, you will be brought to the next page. If not, you may receive an error message stating that there is no match found. If you see this message, double-check your entries to ensure that your first name and last name matches what you have submitted when you applied to Edmonds College. Also, be sure that your birth date is in the format of month, day, and followed by the full year. Finally, double-check that you have selected the correct ID type and entered your ctcLink or SID number correctly. You will be prompted to set up your ctcLink password and account security. First, enter your email address and be sure that you have reliable access to this account. Next, select a security question and enter your answer to that question. Optionally, you may also add a phone number for account recovery via text or voice. Adding this is recommended for recovering your ctcLink account if you don't have access to your email account. Finally, create a new password for your ctcLink account. Be sure to follow the password requirement instructions. Enter your new password in the first box and type the same password again in the last box. Click on Submit and your ctcLink account will be activated. A pop-up window will appear presenting your ctcLink ID. Be sure to record your ctcLink ID before closing this window. Once recorded, you may close this tab and proceed back to the ctcLink login page. Open a new tab and go to gateway.ctclink.us. If you ever forget your ctcLink account password, you may click on Password Help and select Reset Password. Here, you will enter your ctcLink ID and choose an account recovery option. This includes email, or you can choose text or voice if you added a phone number to your account. This will then allow you to create a new password. At the ctcLink login page, enter your ctcLink ID and click on Next. Now, enter your ctcLink account password and click on Verify. If successful, you will be brought to the Edmonds College ctcLink Gateway. Be mindful of any announcements in the center of the page, which may include system outages or information for students and employees. On the left, you will see links to the applications you have access to. This includes Canvas and the student homepage if you are a student. If you are an employee, you will see application and pillar links including Campus Solutions, Human Capital Management, Finance, and more. Do you need further assistance? Visit itsupport.edmonds.edu to visit our IT Help Center. Here, you may explore our online resources, tutorials, and submit a service ticket to request assistance from our IT agents. Thanks for watching.